Please get ready to begin. Sit in a comfortable meditation asana, siddhasana, padmasana, ardha padmasana or swastik asana, or any asana of your comfort. Be aware of your hands. Keep it relaxed and rest your hands either on your knee or on your lap and adopt favorite mudra of your choice. Be aware of your elbows, they are relaxed, shoulders relaxed, chest, abdomen comfortable, spine upright, relax facial muscles and continue with eyes closed. Be aware of you seated in this environment. Be aware of you in the present surrounding, atmosphere. Make you aware of all the sensorial inputs which is acknowledged by your senses. Pay attention to them one by one. Now withdraw your awareness from your senses and make your awareness inward. Be aware of you seated in meditation asana, as if the body has turned into a piece of rock. Feel the stability, firmness, and solidity of your body. And try and experience this state of your being at your mental plane. Our body and mind are the two sides of the same coin. If you are physically relaxed, comfortable, and still, you may experience this state too at your mind. The body is the gross form of the mind, and mind is subtle form of body. Experiencing the relaxation, calmness, peace and stillness at your mind. Now, focus your awareness at your eyebrow center. Visualize a brilliant point of light there. As you focus at this light, we will chant Om three times. Take a deep breath in.
Karavavahe Te
वधितमस्तु मां विद्विषावहे ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ लेट योर माइंड बिकम एक्सटर्नलाइज्ड Connect with the surrounding in space, and as you feel you are completely externalized, practice palming. And open your eyes, relax your legs and lie down in Savasana. Head to my side. And today our journey will be of Pavan Muktasana 2, the anti-gastric series, the practices to strengthen your abdominal muscles, back muscles, leg muscles, to boost your digestive function, reproductive function. Before we begin, just have a feeling of rest and comfort in Savasana. Make sure you are completely relaxed and breathing at your abdomen. Practice abdominal breathing. Pavan Muktasana 2 is being done from supine base pose. Bring your feet together. Bring your hand very close to the body, straight hand, palm facing down. Turn your ankle edge just a bit towards you. Be aware of your shoulder blades. Keep it relaxed and a bit towards each other, not touching. Chest open to allow you to breathe at abdomen with active shoulders, active hand, core muscles and leg. And maintain this posture for the throughout the practice of Pad Uttan Asana. Be aware of right leg. Breathe in. Gently raise the right leg up. Breathe out. Release. Again right. Breathe in. Breathe out. And continue for another 5 rounds. We'll do right leg 7 times, left leg 7 times. Make sure you keep your sitting bone firm, left leg firm and straight, shoulders firm and relaxed. And while you raise your leg up and down, be aware of the effect of practice in your abdominal cavity, in your back muscles, in your leg. After 7 right, start with the 7 left. The Pavan Muktasana 2 practice boosts your digestive health, reproductive health. Strengthen your abdominal muscles, strengthen your back muscles, prevent lower back pain, and also prevent the varicose vein problem. Once you complete the practice, maintain supine base pose. You will relax for some time, connecting with the after effect of the practice. Maintain your feet together in supine base pose. Being in the active mode and getting ready for the next practice. Pad Chakra Asana, starting with the right leg clockwise. So lift your right leg up, breathe in. Breathe out, down, ensuring that you are active with your hand and shoulders, maintaining the firm sitting bone, keeping the left leg straight at the moment. Making a very big circle is not at all the idea. Follow the technique properly. 7 times clockwise, 7 times anti-clockwise. You must count your round. Counting the round is awareness. Sitting bones should not go off the ground for the safety. And be aware of the gentle massage to your abdominal cavity, abdominal muscles and organs. Be aware of involvement of your hip joint. Once you complete 7 both directions, you are going to change practice from right to left. Keeping both knees straight is a very important aspect. Try and use the strength of your leg muscles, shoulders. Try and be aware of your both hands and core muscles. These are the support for the practice. Once you are done with the practice of Padachakra Asana, maintain supine base pose. Continue with the active mode. And in the supine pose itself, try and relax yourself with eyes closed. Relax your thigh muscles, hip joints, abdominal muscles and the back muscles. And we'll take the practice to next Pad Sanchalan, the cycling. Raise your right leg straight up, breathe in. Then bend your knee and make the leg straight, close to the floor but not to touch, and continue. Raise it, bend it and make it straight. 7 times, both the directions. And continue with the experience of Pavan Muktasana 2, its effect on your leg muscles, back muscles, abdominal muscles, abdominal organs. To do Pavan Muktasana 2, you need to be very aligned because these practices are very muscular. Its effect on muscles are very deep and in your abdominal organs. So you must support properly the whole body so that you can maintain your comfort. 7 times both the direction of the cycling, and then you go with other side. Maintain the discipline of the practice, the awareness of the practice, awareness of the counting of number of rounds. All together, this helps you to improve your concentration, improve your quality of awareness. Body movement should be rhythmic, It should be well coordinated with the breath. It should be well coordinated with your awareness. In hand, using awareness of three causes, annamay, pranamay, and manomay. Once you are done with your practice, then continue yourself in supine base pose. In the supine base pose itself, try and relax your whole body. Maintain supine base pose and the discipline, relaxing that itself, feel the body alignment and the comfort, and continue with abdominal breathing experience. Next practice is leg lock pose, Supta Pavan Muktasana. Be aware of right leg. Take a deep breath in, bring the right knee straight to chest, straight to chest. Interlock your finger. As you start breathing out, press the abdomen and then hold the breath out. Touch your head to the knee. Put your head down, relax the pressure from abdomen, and now breathe in, release the leg. There is no raised leg. Again, right leg, breathe in, bring the knee to chest, hold the hand. Breathe out, gently press the abdomen, hold the breath out, and then lift your head to touch, head to the knee. Put your head down, release the pressure from abdomen, and now breathe in, release the leg. Do another three rounds with the right. You must go with two steps. Step number one, to bring the knee to chest and then to press the knee towards the body, to press the abdomen with the thigh, and then you touch your head and knee. Be aware of the compressing abdomen and stretching back muscles. The practice of Supta Pavan Muktasana, leg lock pose. Boosting your digestive function, letting go indigestion, gastric problem, at the same time giving relief to your back muscles, to correct the problem of lumbar lordosis, to relieve tension from sciatic nerve. You must maintain a count of number of rounds that you are doing. And once you complete 5-5 both sides, please come to Savasana and make you relaxed. Once you are done with your rounds, please relax in Savasana and be aware of overall experience of the practices that has been done by you so far. Relax your thigh muscles, your abdomen, back muscles. Relax your whole body. Be aware of the muscular effect of the Pavan Muktasana 2 practices. Our next practice is Supta Udrakarsana. Interlock your finger under your head. Rest your elbows and shoulders are on the floor. Keep the chest open. Maintain feet together. And very gently bend both your knee. Let your heels to touch your sitting bone and feet on the ground. We'll do stage 1 of the practice first. Maintain knee and foot together, and remember you are not supposed to lift your elbows and shoulders. Now twist both your knee together to right and your head to the left. Look at your left elbow. Center. Twist your knee left, head right. Center. Add breath. Breathe in here. As you breathe out, twist knee right, head left. Breathe in center. Breathe out left. Breathe in center. Breathe out right. Breathe in center. Breathe out left. Breathe in center. Now we'll do level two. Bring both your knee to chest. And then twist both your knee to right. As you breathe out, breathe in center. Breathe out left. Breathe in center. That's one round. Do two more like this. And be aware of the practice of Supta Udrakarsan, the squeezing effect that goes to your abdominal organ, muscles, to your spine, easing out the entire lower part of the body. Have a sense of relief at sciatica nerve. Once you are done with the practice, you will maintain foot and knee together. You will just make your legs straight. And raise your both hands at shoulder line to become capital T. To do the next practice, Sava Udrakarsan. Be aware of your left leg. Very gently bend your left knee. And put your left foot on the right knee to press it down to ensure that right leg to remain straight. Now hold the left knee with the right hand from outside and take the left knee towards the right side on the floor. Be aware of both shoulders, left hand firm on the ground. Look at the middle finger of left hand. Extending the twist of Supta Udrakarsan to Sava Udrakarsan. Come back and let go the leg. Bring your right hand to its place. Now bring right knee to chest. Put the foot on the thigh then. And then left hand to go to the right knee. Keep your right hand straight please at shoulder line. And make your twist left. Head right. Come center and let go. There is no raised leg here. Maintain your hand at the shoulder line. If you don't have space, then you can keep your hand interlocked under your head. Again, be aware of your left leg. Breathe in. Bring the knee to chest and put the foot on the thigh and press the knee. And then breathe out with the support of right hand. Twist right. Come back, breathe in center, breathe out, let go the leg. Breathe in, right leg, breathe out, twist with left hand. Breathe in, breathe out. Do one more round by yourself and be aware of the extended abdominal twist. Sava Udrakarsan. Once the practice is done, relax yourself for a moment in Savasana. Next practice is boat pose. You have to lift yourself 30 degrees off the ground, or you may say 1 foot off the ground, your head, shoulder, hand and leg. Bring your feet together, keep your ankle a bit towards you, hands are closed. Breathing in, lift your body and acquire the shape of boat, and breathe out, very gently come down. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Continue for another 4 rounds and be aware of this practice. It's very muscular, looks very simple, but very strong practice for your muscles and abdominal organs. But it is the practice of boosting core strength, very safe practice to let go the fatigue, tightness, boost immunity. Ideal practice before yoga nidra. Once you complete this practice, just have a rest for some time in supine itself, and we'll go for the final practice to neutralize the body, that is Julan Lodhakan Asana. Rocking part of it, bring both your knee to chest, hold your shin bone gently and start the movement. Try and sit down, lie down. When you sit down, it is to sit in a squat, and when you lie down, to touch the toe gently to the ground. Full-fledged form of rocking, as if you are going to give a gentle massage to the whole body. And when you feel you have done maximum rocking, you may stand up directly from here by crossing the feet to standing and come to front of your place. Touch the toe to front line of the mat, and we are going to do Surya Namaskar as our next practice. Stand in front of your place, maintain your firmness and eyes closed, and let go unwanted movement. Maintain the discipline and awareness of the body, and be aware of your feet. Be aware of the balance of your whole body on your feet. Energize your feet by holding your awareness there. And from the feet, raise the awareness towards your head, and head back to the feet, and do this rotation with the breath. While you breathe in, move your awareness from the feet to your head. Breathe out, head back to the feet. Now in front of your closed eyes, visualize the Surya, the rising sun. And bring your hands very gently to pranam mudra, prayer pose. Connect yourself with the blessings, with the blissful rays of the sun. Being connected with the Surya, maintain eyes open or closed. Get ready to begin the practice. Breathe in, Hastuthan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashvasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvatasana. Hold the breath, Stanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvat Asan. Hold the breath, Stanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvat Asan. Hold the breath, Stanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvat Asan. Hold the breath, Shtanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe in, Hastuttan. We are in third round. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvat Asan. Hold the breath, Stanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvat Asan. Hold the breath, Stanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvat Asan. Hold the breath, Stanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Parvat Asan. Hold the breath, Stanga. Breathe in, Bhujang. Breathe out, Parvat. Breathe in, Ashwasanchalan. Breathe out, Padahast. Breathe in, Hastuttan. Breathe out, Pranam. Breathe out, pranam. Breathe in, hastottan. Breathe out, padahast. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Breathe out, parvatasana. Hold the breath, shtanga. Breathe in, bhujang. Breathe out, parvat. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Breathe out, padahast. Breathe in, hastottan. Breathe out, pranam. Breathe out, pranam. Breathe in, hastottan. Breathe out, padahast. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Breathe out, parvatasana. Hold the breath, shtanga. Breathe in, bhujang. Breathe out, parvat. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Breathe out, padahast. Breathe in, hastottan. Breathe out, pranam. Sixth and last round. Breathe out, pranam. Breathe in, hastottan. Breathe out, padahast. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Breathe out, parvatasana. Hold the breath, shtanga. Breathe in, bhujang. Breathe out, parvat. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Breathe out, padahast. Breathe in, hastottan. Breathe out, pranam. Breathe out, pranam. Breathe in, hastottan. Breathe out, padahast. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Breathe out, parvatasana. Hold the breath, shtanga. Breathe in, bhujang. Breathe out, parvat. Breathe in, asvasanchalan. Padahast, hastottan, and pranam. Become steady. Let go unwanted movements. And become aware of your body after the practice of Surya Namaskar. Once again, practice ascending and descending awareness. Mentally scan your body, relax your heartbeat, now very gently cross your feet and sit down back to the floor, go a little back and sit with outstretched leg. Next practice to do is Paschimottanasana. Rest your hand over your knee or over your any part of the leg with the back straight. Be aware of you while seated. Make sure your ankles are towards you. Active with your leg muscles, calf and hamstring. Back should be straight and a little arched to have sacroiliac nutation in form of a bit arch, so that when you bend forward you will land with a straight body. Breathing in, raise your hands up, stretch you up, lengthening the spine to create little more gap between the vertebrae, and with a straight back using your hip, bend a little forward and then maintaining the straight spine, minimum flexion of your spine using your rectus abdomini muscles, that's your core muscles. Bend forward and keep bending you forward to a maximum comfortable point. And if you have back pain, do not try to bend too much forward. And once you are all set, In the practice, very gently close your eyes. Be aware of your spine, which is landed in primary curve of the spine at the moment, the spine of the newborn baby or the shape of the spine in the womb of mother. This is the primary curve of the spine, and in this state of the spine, the blood circulation in your back muscles, in your spine, is at the best. The posture balances your Ida and Pingala and awakens Sushumna. That's why it is called Paschimottanasana. Paschima means the back, and in term of yoga, in yoga philosophy, the back also represents Sushumna Nadi. To bring your awareness in Sushumna and from there to expand your consciousness, Paschima Tan, the back is stretched. The word Tan has come from Tantra, which means expansion of consciousness. One of the highly regarded practice of yoga, Paschimottanasana, simply relax you in the posture with slow and deep breath. Either let your whole body be your awareness, or meditate at your pubic bone, or rotate your awareness between pubic bone and throat in the frontal passage. From here, hold for another 10 breaths. If you feel a stiff back, do not try to bend too much forward. A little bit is okay. You must realize your strength. Once you are done from where I left you, you will come out of the posture. You will bend your knee one by one and make you sit in Vajrasana. As a counterpose, we will either do Ardha Ustrasana or Ustrasana or Supta Vajrasana. Choose one practice to hold for 20 breaths. If you are doing Ardha Ustrasana, 10 right, 10 left. Just try and retain the posture. Some of you are in half, some of you are in full, and some of you are in Supta Vajrasana. In Supta Vajrasana, try and keep the crown on the floor and try and keep your knee on the ground. Try to keep your knee together, elbow on the floor, palm on the thigh. 20 breaths, Ustrasana. Supta Vajrasana, if you are in Ardha Ustrasana, 10 right side, 10 breath left side. After completing this practice, we are going to lie down ourselves in Savasana.
Once you are done, lie down in Savasana. And the final practice to do is practice of one inverted. You may choose Kandharasana. In case if you can't go to any of the full inverted posture, otherwise you may adopt either Viprit Karni Mudra Asana or Sarvanga Asana. So get ready to begin the next practice. Kandhar, this is half inverted, backward bending, or you may do Viprit Karni Mudra Asana or Sarvang Asana. Only one posture to be done, either Kandhar or Sarvang or Viprit Karni Mudra Asana. In Viprit Karni Mudra Asana, the torso to be held at 45 degrees. And in Sarvangasana, try to make your torso full perpendicular to the floor. If you are not able to do it at the moment, wherever you are, try to be relaxed and gentle there. To do these inverted asanas, you need balance, strength, and flexibility. If you have these three, you will be a perfect inverted asana practitioner. But wherever you are, you must realize the state of your body and your awareness at the moment. Now we are going to come out of the posture. Drop your leg towards your head and bend your knee. Take it towards a bit towards your forehead and then gently drop your body down. We are not going to halasana. As a contrapose, when you are comfortable, you may do Matsyasana. Matsyasana can be done with a straight leg, that is a Saral Matsyasana, or you can do it from Padmasana. So your wish, how you want to do it, switch yourself to the next practice. Matsyasana, the fist pose. If you can't sit in Padmasana, it can be done with a straight leg, that is the Saral Matsyasana. But wherever you are, try to be relaxed, satisfied, and be aware of the contour practice. Once you are done with the practice, Relax for some time in Savasana. Leg apart, hands away, palm facing up. Fingers naturally curled. Close your eyes. Adjust your body and try and hold yourself in a very relaxed mode in Savasana. Keeping the body free from any discomfort, any tension. Bring the state of complete stillness and relaxation and peace within you. Mentally scan your body from toe to head. Breathe in, head down to the toe, breathe out. Practice ascending and descending awareness from the toe to head. Breathe in, head down to the toe, breathe out. Let your awareness to connect with your body parts. And let the awareness of body part become relaxation, become vitality for them. Simply relax yourself in Savasana, the most natural posture to relax, to create balance in your autonomous nervous system, in your Ida Pingala, bringing back your vitality, letting go fatigue and feeling refreshed and relaxed. Continue relaxing the body by guiding your awareness from toe to head while breathing, head to the toe while you breathe out. Visualize your awareness and breath together has become a ring of light. And this ring of light is also being rotated between your toe and your head. As your breath and awareness move from your toes towards your head, feel this ray of light also move up and then down. And now let go the awareness of relaxation of the body. Once again reconnect yourself with outside environment. Be aware of the people around and be aware of yourself. Start practicing slow and deep breathing. And once you find you are comfortable, move your toes, your feet, your hands, your head to the sides. Stretch you nicely. And then please sit down. Sit down and we will do practice of pranayama. If you like, you may roll your mat so that your sitting posture will be more firm and helping you to do proper breathing to maintain the firmness of your whole being. Try and find a comfortable meditative asana for you and rest your both hands over the knee in Chinna Mudra or Jnana Mudra. Keep your body upright and straight and eyes are closed. Relax your whole body mentally. Today we are going to do the first practice as Surya Bhed Pranayam. Surya Bhed Pranayam is half Nadi Shodhan, where only right channel is being used. You have to inhale through the right, exhale through the left, and that makes one round. Right in, left out, and make it 1:1. So bring any of your hand into action as you do in Nadi Shodhan Pranayam. Close your left nostril and gently inhale through the right. The breath should be silent, slow and deep. It is to breathe in through right, breathe out through left. Surya Bhed Pranayam, to penetrate, to awaken Pingala Nadi. Awakening the vital aspect of your body. The Surya Bhed Pranayam is a hitting practice to boost body immunity, to boost body ability to fight with infection, virus, bacteria, to boost your respiratory health. This practice is being done, but it has contraindication also. If you feel your mind is very hyper or you have high blood pressure, then this practice is not for you. Next round, make it 1:1:1. Breathe in right, then hold the breath, then breathe out left, and keep the time interval equal for inhalation, internal breath retention, and then exhalation. This will be your last round of the practice. Once you are done, please relax your hand and maintain the state of meditative awareness. Connect with the effect of the practice of Surya Bhed Pranayam. Next practice to do, the practice of Kapalbhati in one round, 60 breath, followed by Antarkumbhak Jalandhar and Moolbandh. Today we will do 60 breaths in one round. So when you are ready, you can start. Awareness of forehead, kapal. Maintain the tempo of 60 breaths per minute, means 1 second for one breath, that is in and out. Forced exhalation, normal inhalation, natural inhalation. So begin the practice, please. After completing 60, practice Antar Kumbhak, Jalandhar and Moolbandh. This is also vitalizing practice, hitting practice to relax your forehead, to boost your relaxation of your nervous system, to energize your whole being, to boost your immunity, your respiratory system, and also to boost body ability to fight with infection, virus, bacteria. This practice will be very helpful. Do Antar Kumbhak, Jalandhar Mool. Make sure you are not doing Udyan Bandh. It is Antar Kumbhak with Jalandhar and Mool Bandh. If you don't know these two practices, after every round of Kapalbhati, you rest for 3 to 5 breaths. We have 2 more rounds to go. Awareness of kapal, and confine this movement to your abdomen. Don't try to hit your abdomen hard. Allow exhalation to be forced and inhalation to be natural, normal, gentle. Don't try to drop yourself, maintain the quality exhalation. The rhythm of the breathing out and natural inhalation should sound very pleasant. We have one more round to go, and do with proper quality. Do not try to hit your abdomen too hard. After completing Kapalabhati Pranayama, next we are going to do practice of Nadi Shodhan Pranayama 1:2. We have done 2 hitting practice. We need to do something balancing the hitting effect, and we will do the ratio 1:2 of Nadi Shodhan Pranayama. The starting nostril will be left, and I will guide your first round. We'll start with minimum count, that is 5, breathe in, 10, breathe out. Even you can do more better count than this, try and accommodate with that count. Before we start, make your breath yogic. When you inhale, fill your abdomen, then your chest. While you exhale, relax your chest and abdomen. The entire area of the lungs has to be involved. Now get ready to begin. Bring your hand into action. Close your right nostril. Keep your left open. And breathe out completely. Now breathe in left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Close your left nostril, open the right, slowly breathe out in 10 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now right breathe in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Left breathe out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now relax your hand down. So you must have got the idea now. Release your hand, take a couple of normal breath, and then start the first round by yourself. If you feel you can do more than 5 counts, then you can choose 6. Then it will be 6 and 12, 7, then 7 and 14. So make sure that when you exhale, it is double the inhalation. So continue with your practice. 1:2. Breathe in, double breathe out. To balancing the effect of 2 hitting practice, and also to have more relaxation, increasing the relaxation response of your brain, that is very important. Relaxation is also very important to boost your immunity. Remember that, not just with pranayama, the vitalizing one will help you to boost immunity, but also the practices of meditation, yoga, nidra, boost your immunity. If you are relaxed, your immunity functions at the best. If you are stressed, that suppresses your immunity. Keep this in your mind. And this Nadi Shodhan, what you are doing, 1:2, has very deep relaxation response. Exhalation is an act of relaxation, giving me more awareness to exhalation help you to increase the relaxation response of the practice to your brain. If you feel suffocated, stop the practice, relax and restart. From the next round, we'll try and make it 1:2, 1:2. If you feel you are not ready for that, then you continue with 1:1. 1:2, 1:2 means after inhalation, try and retain your breath for same count, then you exhale double. That is called 1:2, 1:2. But if you are not ready for that, please continue with 1:2. Focus of eyebrow center, silent breath, but make sure it is slow, deep yogic breath. Working with the 3 aspects of your breath, duration, depth, force, to control the three elements of the breath, that is Rechak, Purak, Kumbhak. And we are not doing bandhas. So just keep it simple. Inhalation, retention, double exhalation if possible. This will be your last round of the practice. Once you are done, relax your hand. Continue with eyes closed. Maintain still body and meditative awareness. And your awareness will come back at the eyebrow center. Connect with your eyebrow center. And once again there, visualize a bright spot of light, a candle flame. And try and hold your concentration on this light. We'll chant three Oms and three Om Shanti, followed by three rounds of palming. Take a deep breath in. Let temperature to come and place the palm up of your eye. Relax your eyes and facial muscles and then your throat. Hari Om Tatsat.